Hello, my name is Morara Kempaso.
Sono insomma Nini, DCI.
Sì, hai una tranquilla con Leona, tocchia.
Momento, mica sirene.
The following video captures the scene where Morara Kebaso was abducted and kicked inside the Subaru car by a man claiming to be law enforcement. The video shows a man and a woman tries to follow up at the Subaru that Morara was kicked in, but their efforts didn't bear any fruit. This happened after Morara yesterday gave his statement concerning the news of a trending, which are trending on social media following the case of Bruce, a blogger who was sodomized because of written in about a politician in Mombasa.
My name is Morara Kebaso. I'm the leader of the Inclusive National Justice, Economic and Civic Transformation Party of Kenya, which is also known as the Inject Party of Kenya and the Kenya Ni Home Movement. And today I've been saddened after watching a video of Bruce, who was sodomized in a very sad event in Mombasa. 25-year-old Bruce John, who goes by the name Chawa001, was abducted and sodomized on the September 12th of 2024. He was picked up by more than 20 people from his home, some of whom were county officials, allegedly to go and apologize to the governor of Mombasa, Abdul Somad Sharif Nasir, for criticizing the county government of Mombasa. The gentleman was instead not taken to Tamarind Hotel, where he'd been told that he would apologize to the governor, but was instead sodomized in Miritini area and later dumped near Mwakirunge dump site. This is a very sad event, and much as some of the suspects have been arrested and charged in court, we cannot be a country where we only arrest the small fish. The Inspector General of Police, Douglas Kanja, should come out clearly and tell the nation whether the governor of Mombasa, Abdul Somad Sharif Nasir, is above the law. These people clearly did not do this evil act by themselves. This was a coordinated attack against the Constitution and against the freedom of expression to pick up a young gentleman in his 25 years, full of dreams and full of hopes, and to destroy his life by turning him on his back and sodomizing him in a very, very sad event, which I've watched on video and I've been unable to watch it twice. I'm under a lot of pain and anger after watching this video, and I believe this is the feeling of most of the Kenyans. And therefore, I would like to issue a statement and state as follows. I am giving the Inspector General of Police, Douglas Kanja, an ultimatum to arrest the Governor of Mombasa, Abdul Somad Sharif Nasir, to answer to charges of being an accessory to crime and being a conspirator to crime. Sodomy is such a demeaning thing to any man or to any boy. It destroys a person's life and their dreams and their hope of ever living a normal life again. I know Bruce has received treatment, but I don't know whether if that happened to you or to your son or to your brother, whether they'll ever be able to live a normal life again. If the governor of Mombasa is not investigated, arrested, and charges preferred upon him for conspiring, hiring these criminals, then I'm ready, willing, and able to stop all my activities and lead a nationwide demonstration to demand for accountability of this governor. We have become a nation that is tolerant to criminals, and to make it worse, we've even elected criminals into our elective institution. Today in Parliament, we have a person who shot someone during election day. That person died. The family lost someone. People cried. And to this day, we've not seen accountability. We live in a country where several people died in Shakahola. The government has never been accountable as to how many people died, why they died, and who killed them, but instead has gone for the small fish. We live in a country where people have been abducted, tortured, and killed, and some have been found in quarries, and there has been no accountability. No single police officer has been arrested. None of them has been charged in court. The Independent Police Oversight Authority keeps pussyfooting on this issue, yet they are funded by taxpayers' money to work. So we wonder what work they are doing. We live in a country where several bodies were retrieved from quarry, and to this day, the person who killed them was released from jail, and the police tried to lie to us that this person escaped through a gap in the wire mesh, a gap that had already rusted, which was clearly not a fresh cut. There has been no accountability for those deaths in a police-orchestrated escape. We cannot continue like this. We cannot continue as a country that glorifies criminality, glorifies the torture and killing of citizens, glorifies the demeaning and the complete annihilation of life like the way it has been done to Bruce, who has been turned on his back and sodomized. Therefore, this is a warning to the new Inspector General. The Constitution gives you independent powers as the Inspector General of our nation to be independent and to exercise your power independently. If you are unable to do so, I would like to let you know that you drive public money, you sleep in public money, you eat public money, the uniform you are wearing is public money, the gun you have is public money, the bullets you have are public money. The public even buys you airtime. If you are unable to work, your tenure is going to be the shortest tenure of any Inspector General. And I'm not just speaking for myself, but on behalf of very many Kenyans who are pained by the sheer lack of compassion that is with the people that hold high offices, including the office of the DCI. Therefore, the Inspector General, together with the DCI, Mohamed Amin, if we do not see action within the next few days, be assured, be rest assured, take it as a joke at your own risk, that we are going to demonstrate non-stop, day and night without stop, until the perpetrators of this heinous crime are brought to book. Thank you, and God bless you.
Today, Morara's case will be listed in Milimani Law Court, and the protesters have already in the area. And one message they have for the judges and everyone in law court is that they should.
Hapa ni tuko roundabout ya university.
Okay.
Ingia jia Serena.
Tunaenda Moranga Road. Moranga. Tuko university way. Haya, tumeshapita, tunaingia Globe roundabout. I saw. Ongeza mbio.
Tumepita sentry, so si sentry.
I saw. Hii gari sipotee.
I was thinking. Watu wengine waneza wajoin. Kama wakona gari.
Tuko saizi Globe roundabout, guys. Tunaingia. Shit. Yo, tumeingia sasa tunaenda. Tuko hapa na wao. Hapa kwa hapa.
Yeah.
kwa Thika Road. Gari ingine guys ni KCQ 117J.
Zote ni Volkswagen Tiguan.
Volkswagen Tiguan.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Guys, ni kama tunaingia njia kwenda Kiambu, tuko Kiambu Road sasa. Tuko Kiambu. Tuko DCI, tuko DCI, Kiambu. Tuko DCI Kiambu. Tumeingia DCI Kiambu. Tana ingia pale.
Ruto asikwe. Ruto atiliwe. Ruto asikwe. Ruto atiliwe.
Alafu mambo ya mtu kutoka kwa uongozi alafu tunasema let them retire in peace, hiyo mambo lazima iishe. How can somebody retire in peace when they've stolen money? Si warudishe ndio wa retire in peace. Unapata governor ametoka kwa uongozi, alikuwa ni mwizi, ameiba billions and billions of money that is meant for healthcare, that is meant for schools, that is meant for roads, that is meant for street lights, that is meant for sewage. Then we just start saying ati huyu jamaa wacha aende retire, ati he did his work. Which work? Alifanya wizi. You know, I get very surprised when people keep saying, oh, you know, Uhuru is now retired president, wacheni kusumbua Uhuru, wacha Uhuru apumzike, he did his part, it is now time to move on, there is no need to awaken old grudges. Which grudges? Which grudges? Kwani kuitisha public money yenye imeibiwa ni grudges? Why are we letting Uhuru retire peacefully with Eurobond? Why? Why are we letting Uhuru retire peacefully with money for laptops? Why are we letting Uhuru retire peacefully with SGR? Why? There's no reason to let these people retire peacefully. Mimi, kama ingekuwa ati niko na uwezo, hakuna kiongozi ambaye angeretire peacefully akiwa ameiba pesa ya wananchi. Ile kitu ya kwanza ambayo ingefanya retire peacefully ni kwanza arudishe ile pesa. But now people come to government, they steal for 10 years, then after they've left government, we start praising them as if they were very good people. Ni kama vile tunafanyanga kwa matanga. And this culture ya Wakenya lazima iishe. Hii culture yenye ilikuanga kwa matanga, yenye alikuwa ni muizi, mnamjua ni muizi, lakini kwa matanga yake akisha kufa mnamsifu. Hata Apostle Kiande aliimba hiyo kitu. Alikuwa ni mwizi twamjua, mweke pema peponi. Si mnakumbuka hiyo wimbo? Let us stop tolerating people. Mtu akitoka kwa serikali direct paka jela, mwenye alikuwa mwizi. For example, Ruto, he belongs in prison after government. Mtu imagine ati Ruto, Uhuru, the last thing he did kabla hii election ya Ruto itangazwe
The very, very last thing he did was to withdraw 12.5 billion from the treasury. Ati inaenda kununua shares za Africa Export Import Bank, za Africa Trade and Development Bank, ati na Jamhuri Holdings. 12.5 billion. This guy withdrew that money in one day. Ana withdraw pesa kutoka kwa treasury ni kama ni mpesa yake. And then we let him retire peacefully. How? Why? Munaona Gashagwa sahi anazurura na mtu anaitwa Malala. This is a guy who just recently was holding a position called cabinet secretary without portfolio. Amekula public money, ame drive public money, ame enjoy public money. This guy should refund every single shilling that he earned as a cabinet secretary without portfolio. What do you mean a minister without ministry? That's like saying car without engine. Yeah? What is that? Iyo ni nini? Ah. Hii mchezo imekuwa mbaya bwana. Ah. This joke is bad. This joke is bad. It's bad. We must drain the swamp. Na hakuna mtu tunabembeleza. Hata Gashagwa asituambia ati historia wa Kikuyu sijui nini. Kikuyu businesses suffered under Uhuru. Yetu Uhuru was a Kikuyu. In fact, Kikuyu's trusted him wakasema ati huyu ni billionaire hana haja ya kuiba. The guys told them dry. Businesses collapsed when Uhuru was in power. But Uhuru's businesses did well. He even started a new bank. Mumetuzoea kutumia ukabila na kutudanganya kwamba ati kwa sababu mnatoka kwa kabila yetu mnatujali. Hakuna Wakikuyu ambao Gashagwa anajali. Gashagwa is fighting for his stomach. He is simply saying, Ruto umeiba sana, niachie pia mimi niibe kidogo. Ama ile yenye nimeiba haijanitosha, nataka pia kuiba kidogo, wacha kunikazia. Kwanza huyo mtu hiyo 200 million yenye alirudishiwa yenye ilikuwa tayari imefriziwa na koti, which was proceeds of corruption from counties. Hiyo pesa tayari ashachukua. Alikuwa na kesi ya 7 billion ya kuibia wa Kenya. The first thing aliingia, ali influence DPP, DPP akawithdraw hiyo kesi. Kwani mnachezea hii pesa mnafikiri ni yenu? Gashagwa, is this your money? Ruto, is this your money? Do you know that when a Kenyan pays 50 shillings token, 20 shillings inakuanga ni tax? Hii pesa siyo yenu? Hii pesa ni ya wa Kenya. When a Kenya buys a kilo, a Kenyan buy a kilo of sugar, 100 bob tax. Mkenya kinunua mkate, Mkenya kinunua kitabu ya mtoto wa shule, kuna tax hapo ndani. Hii pesa ni ya wa Kenya, siyo pesa yenu. So stop talking to us with a lot of impunity and a lot of braggadocia. Yeah? As if this is your money. Sahi mnaendelea kuiba 104 billion from Ministry of Health through this thing called Apiero, which is owned by Adani. Bana nyinyi mnatufanyia mchezo. Nyinyi mko na bahati sana, amjawahi kupata rais ambaye hayuko conflicted. Amna dirt on him. Na ako ready kupigana na corruption. Iyo ndo ile bahati mko nayo. Amjai pata mtu tu mwenye ako a person of integrity mwenye ataka kupigana na corruption. Ile siku mtapatana na mtu kama huyo, I can assure you, William Ruto, you are not going back to ICC. You will go to jail, and not abroad kwa wazungu. You will go to jail here in Kenya, and it's possible. Na hata kufanyike maandamano Rift Valley, huyo rais ataenda huko Rift Valley aeleze watu wa Rift Valley chenye umewaibia. Kumbuka Ruto akiiba si ati inasaidia wakale. Kwani Ruto akiiba, kwani hiyo nyumba yenye Ruto amejenga Kilgoris yenye kopaka na airport mahali ana land, wakale wanaishi huko? Mkale mwenye alikuwa njaa si bado ako njaa leo? Mkale hakuwa na kazi, si huyo mkale njini paka sahi ana kazi? Sasa tutatetea Ruto atusaidie na nini? Kama Ruto anataka kusema kweli yeye ni mkale, si afanyie wakale maendeleo? Kama ni kazi ni kugrab mashamba ya wakale, kwani Kerenga stadium yenye, Kerenga airstrip yenye wameiba, kwani hiyo iko Kikuyuni ama iko Lodwar? Sini ya wakale. Kipkaren water dam projects yenye wamepora pesa, kwani si huko ni kwa wakale? Kamarini stadium yenye imekulwa, kwani si huko ni kwa wakale? Eldoret airstrip yenye wamepanda mahindi kwa airstrip na ngano, si huko ni kwa wakale njini? Msidanganywe na mambo ya ukabila. Na mimi hata nataka kwanza Wakenya nikiongeza wa funding, ni recruit volunteers, nifanye civic education to every village. Nataka niende mashinani mahali hadi network haishikangi. Huko mahali labda hata wa watch TV. Nataka nifike huko, I open the eyes of Kenyans. Watu wache kufikiria ati hawa siasa wanatujali. Ni kipindi na sinema wanashinda wakitupigisha hapa.